welcome to our Bears at Home today. Today it's Wednesday, and Wednesday is our exercise time. But today our exercise is going to be very different from the last few weeks. We're going to be looking at and playing sensory rugby. Now, we've played sensory rugby in schools, we've played sensory rugby in community centres and spaces. We've even played sensory rugby at local rugby clubs, our specialist indoor sensory version of rugby. But today, for the first time ever, we're going to try playing sensory rugby at home and online, so we can bring it to you so that you can join in with us as well. Now, it's really important to us that it works for you and that it is meaningful and it's good fun for all of you at home. So please do tell us if it works for you, what you find hard or challenging, and we can try our best to make it even better for you or to help you. Now, you will need a few things, so have a look at what I've collected, because these things are what I'm going to need to play sensory rugby today. So first of all, you're going to need a ball. It could be a rugby ball or any other kind of ball, or instead you could use something like a cushion to help you, or a rolled up jumper or something like that. And then something long or stretchy like a TheraBand. But if you don't have a TheraBand, you could use a scarf perhaps. Make sure you ask before you borrow it. A long thin scarf, something stretchy perhaps. Similarly, you'll be able to just stretch with your bodies for that element of the game. Today I'm going to be using the rugby ball and the TheraBand. Instead of ribbons, I'm going to be thinking about using my scarves, I think, today. Now, as you've seen, there are lots of different ways that we can use our objects. You might not have the ball, so you can use your cushion or your jumper instead. You might not have a TheraBand, so we can think about using a scarf. So don't worry, use what is best for you to get involved in the game. If you really need help with any of the objects, if we can, we will. So drop me an email, give us a shout on social media, and we'll do our best to help you. But now, it's time to play some sensory rugby. So, let's get ready for our first track. Now, the basic premise of sensory rugby is to recreate the game through a sensory and tactile medium, using objects, music and physical interaction to recreate what it really feels like to be involved in key elements of the game: the kickoff, the tackle, scrum, line out, scoring a try, and then the final whistle, the camaraderie that finishes the game. So we start with a signature song and we finish with a signature song. And then the six elements in between that come with their own music track each, with a simple and physical interaction. Our first track, though, is our rugby song. I'm going to play our rugby song now, and it's just the time to relax. So get yourself comfortable in your chair, on a bed, on the floor. However you are comfortable, get in that position, ready to play some sensory rugby. If you need some extra time, hit pause now and get yourself into position. So by now, you should be nice and comfortable, ready to start our sensory rugby. Are you ready? Excellent. Because it's time for rugby. It's our rugby song. So quiet time. Preparation time. Thinking. Being ready for rugby. It's time for rugby! Oh,
take the time to relax, to get yourself ready. It's time for rugby! Taking your rugby ball or your jumper or your cushion, I want you to hold it. As the music track plays, you're going to hold your ball. You might spend the whole time exploring and feeling the sensory properties of the ball. You could be massaging your legs and your body, holding and squeezing the ball. Our kickoff introduces the ball to the game. We need the ball to start the game. It's time for the kickoff. Squeeze that ball. Hold that ball. Our tackle is all about the physical interaction, the contest for the ball. It's the first time we meet the opposition physically, and it's about getting shoulder to shoulder, wrapping the arms, hitting each other, bringing each other down, the competition for the ball, the physical competition, the physical contact. It's a great one to do with someone in your family, because what you really want is someone to grab, squeeze your shoulders, or to push against you, so you can push back against them as well for our tackle. So, if you can get someone in your family to help you, fantastic. If not, I'm going to be using the edge of the sofa. I'm going to sit comfortably, and this is going to be my opposition. Are you ready, sofa? Because I'm ready to play some rugby. It's the tackle. Watch out! Here comes the other team. It's the tackle! Give them a nudge. Give them a push. Maybe start with something more gentle. Feel those shoulders. Shoulder areas where we're going to make that tackle. Feel it. Give it a squeeze. Big squeeze. And then maybe start going for the tackle. Pushing against. Having a push. Pushing back. Big tackle. Get physical. Have a push. Have a good shove. Squeeze the shoulders. Squeeze the arms. Ready? Here comes the tackle. Squeeze. Ready, ready, ready. Squeeze. And again, ready. Squeeze. On those shoulders, on those arms. Give them a push. If they're pushing you, push back. Keep pushing. Big tackles. Good tackling. Push it. Push it. Squeeze those arms. All the way up the arms. Round the shoulders. All the way around. In for the tackle. In they go. Tackle. Push in. Good tackle. Now the line out is all about the stretch. The competition for the ball when the ball's gone off of the pitch. Making yourself as long as you can to compete and contest to get the ball back. It's all about the stretch for us. You could be using a TheraBand, the resistance band, to help you to stretch. Stretching that band out. You could be holding it and someone else pulls, or someone else could hold it and you pull. Loop your arms, pull against. Loop your legs and pull against. Similarly, if you don't have a TheraBand, you could use a scarf, something to stretch and pull against. You can find a scarf or something long or something stretchy in your house. Also, you could just stretch your body. Stretch your arms really tall, really wide, really long on the floor. If you have a physio routine or a physio program, this is a great way to do it without it just being your physio. You could spend some time stretching to the music as part of the line out. Okay, time to stretch. The ball's off the pitch. We need to get it back in play. Here comes the line out. Big stretch for the line out.
Stretch for that line out. Ready, ready, ready. Stretch. And your other arm. Ready, stretch. Stretch for that line out. Ready, ready, ready. Stretch. Just use your hands. And again, ready, ready, ready. Stretch. Stretch. Good stretching. Good line out. Now our scrum is another chance to get really physical. 16 players coming together to compete for the ball to restart the game. Really, really intense, really close, really physical. Feeling around the neck, the shoulders, the head area, your arms involved. A bit like our tackle, but much more intense. Maybe curling up in a ball, getting tight as though you're in the middle of those 16 players. Could be gentle around the shoulders, all the way through to a very physical front row setup. It's time for a scrum. Get ready. Starts with the shoulders. Get your shoulders going. Right in the neck, squeeze those shoulders. Maybe in time to the music. It's intense music. It's the scrum! Time to squeeze in on someone if you've got someone now. Squeeze in an arm on an arm. Shoulder to shoulder, have a squeeze. And the other side, link up to the other person, squeeze. Feel that squeeze, two hands on their shoulders, in the scrum, squeeze it tight. And the other side. Squeeze, right in tight, squeeze in the scrum. On your shoulders, squeeze it around those shoulders, squeeze it, squeeze tight, tight. Big squeeze in on yourself, someone's hands on you. Big squeeze tight, big squeeze tight. In on someone's shoulder. Both hands in for the scrum. In the front row, squeeze for the scrum. Good scrum. All that work, all that competition, now it's time to finish the move off, to score a try. You could use your therabands, or your scarves, or some ribbons, or some pretty colours, if you have them, some strings. I'm going to use a different scarf. I'm going to wave this. I'm going to cheer, I'm going to celebrate. Because I'm going to score some tries. Lots of colours, lots of movement.
because the fans are going crazy. You've just scored a try. They're cheering for you. Let's get ready. It's a try. You've got the ball. You're going to score. It's a try. The final whistle. The match comes to an end and the teams all come together to shake hands. The teamwork, the camaraderie, the respect after all that contest and competition is finished. We're going to bring the physicality right down. Handshaking, patting on the back, forearm clasping, talking about what went well today. What did you enjoy about the rugby? What was good in the rugby? Talk to the people that you played with. Tell them what they were good at. So bringing the game to an end, but bringing everyone together for the final whistle. Good game. Well done. Good job. Played well today. Have a gentle massage to bring the game to an end. Played well. Fantastic. Give me five. Really good game. Pat on the back. Well done. For me? Thank you. I thought I did really well in the tackle. You were great at rugby. Fantastic. Oh, bigger game. We end our game in the same way we started, a quiet time, a reflecting time, just to think about what we've done as we listen to our rugby song. We start with our rugby song, we end with our rugby song. Thank you for joining us for rugby. Rugby is coming to an end. It's a rugby song. Rugby is coming to an end. Time, a relaxing time to finish, thinking about your rugby today. Rugby is coming to an end.
Well, that was really great fun. I love playing sensory rugby with you at home. I'd like to know what you think, so please do tell me. But in the meantime, have a really good day. We'll see you soon. Thank you very much. Goodbye.